thus is fiber, and thus is fiber. Storm with the speakers blast. Oh, where's Melanza, and welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about fiber and the state of fiber in South Africa. The first thing we're going to be talking about is the availability. If you're seeing cables like this, as thin as this, they look like spaghetti, because these look like spaghetti on wooden poles like street lamps or something. It's fiber, you understand? Moving on to the next point, which is accessibility. You have to have an ISP and you have to have fiber infrastructure providers. These two separate entities is what makes up the whole fiber connection as a whole. Before continuing, I would like to put it out there though that some infrastructure providers will provide you with an internet, but not all of them is doing that. As the consumer, you need to consider your own factors that will determine which ISP that you want to choose to give you internet service on your fiber infrastructure provided, right? Now that I'm done with the point of accessibility, I would like to move on to affordability. In this point, I will be showing you guys the different prices of fiber on different infrastructure providers and different internet service providers. I chose three fiber infrastructure providers and three internet service providers. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have the fiber infrastructure provider, and then I will sub-categorize the ISPs in there. Without wasting time, let's get to it. So I will first give the value for the download by the upload speed, and then the price in rand. For example, I will be saying 20 by 20 equals 950, right? So that means 20 megabits download by 20 megabits upload equals 950 rands. You understand? So back to what I was saying. So back in court, I was saying, this could be yours, what you playing? Our first internet service provider that we're going to be using. Metro Fiber is the fiber infrastructure provider for this category, and then Every House is the internet service provider. We're going to start with 20 by 20 megabits is 500 rand. 50 by 50 megabits, 800 rand. 250 by 250 megabits is 900 rand. 400 by 400 megabits is 1000 rand. 500 by 500 megabits is 1200. And then 1000 by 250 megabits is 1300. 1000 megabits obviously being gigabit, so that is gigabit speed, right? Then on to Telkom, 20 by 20 megabits is 600 rand. 50 by 50 megabits is 750 rand. 100 by 100 megabits is 850 rand. 400 by 400 megabits is 1100 rand. And 500 by 500 megabits is 1200. Our third internet service provider is Supersonic, right? Supersonic, 20 by 20 megabits is 450 rand. 50 by 50 megabits is 700 rand. 100 by 100 megabits is 800 rand. By 500 megabits is 1100, and 1000 by 250 megabits is 1300. So there we have the results for Metro Fiber, and the three internet service providers is Every House, Telkom and Supersonic, right? And that's the prices that we have on the Metro Fiber infrastructure line. So now we're going to be moving on to Frogfoot, right? And Frogfoot is a infrastructure provider. However, we're still using the same three internet service providers that I've chosen. On Frogfoot, we have Every House. By 500 megabits per second, 1380. On to the next internet service provider, which is Telkom. IT by 20 megabits is 700 rand. 40 by 40 megabits is 750. 250 by 50 megabits is 950 rands, and then 200 and 250 megabits is 1,000 rand in 100. Supersonic 80 by 80 megabits is 850 rand. By 250 megabits is 1,100 rand. 500 by 500 megabits is 1,300 rand. In 1,000 by 200 megabits is 1,500 rand. So that is supersonic on Frogfoot, right? And that is the last ISP for the Frogfoot infrastructure provider. On to our last infrastructure provider is Vumatel. Here we have Everyhost as the first internet service provider, right? So we have Everyhost 25 by 25 megabits per second is 450 rand. 50 by 50 megabits is 730 rand. 100 by 100 megabits is 930 rand. 200 by 200 megabits is 1050. 500 by 200 megabits is 1200. 1000 by 200 megabits is 1500. 1000 by 500 megabits is 2350. We're on to the next internet service provider, which is Telkom, right? So Telkom, we have 50 by 50 megabits and it's 800 rand. 100 by 100 megabits is 950 rand. 200 by 200 megabits is 1100. And 500 by 200 megabits is 1350. And that's on Telkom. Now on Supersonic, 50 by 50 megabits is 700 rand. 200 by 200 megabits is 1000 rand. 500 by 200 megabits is 1150. 1000 by 250 megabits is 1450. In 1000 by 500 megabits is 2300 rands. That is the pricing for the internet service providers in their respective infrastructure providers. A lot of people are so focused on how fast is the Wi-Fi, how fast is the line speed, but they never really look at the latency and the bandwidth. Bandwidth and latency, in my opinion, is even more important than the download speed. So there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. That is the last point, which is affordability. And what we can gather from here is that the pricing of 5G in South Africa is not too bad. A lot of people might look at it and say, but those prices is not cheap. However, when you compare it with other countries in Africa, you would actually see that the prices of 5G in South Africa is way better. One thing that I have picked up about these price differences is that the internet service provider charges different prices based on the infrastructure provider at large. Fiber infrastructure providers may vary according to the class of your neighborhood. So that's one thing that we have to understand about fiber and how fiber infrastructure works and how fiber infrastructures work together with the internet service provider to provide internet into your household or to provide fiber optic internet into your household. Now, Shane.
You know what I'm saying? Yummy!
I want to the last point, which is announcements. I've been speed testing for a while now, more specifically to MTN's 5G. So I will be expanding now to speed testing different fiber internet service providers and infrastructure providers. So for the sake of reliability, I will be using a Cat 6 Ethernet cable. Unfortunately, I might not have access to every single ONT. So therefore, I might not be able to use the Ethernet cable connection. However, I will use a Wi-Fi connection, preferably a 5 gigahertz one. But this is subject to the ONT of whichever fiber I will be speed testing, right? So when you guys see the speed test, you're just going to see fiber speed test, and then the internet service provider's name, and then the fiber infrastructure provider's name, and then fiber South Africa, right? However, understand one thing also, another thing is that not every single time I will have access to the infrastructure provider's name. I will try my best to get it, but then not every, if it's not provided, then I can't, because I don't want to just guess and then give you people, you know, the wrong one. For example, if I'm speed testing Everyhost fiber on Vumatel's line, but I don't know that Vumatel is the infrastructure provider. Now, if I go right there, Everyhost and Frogfoot, and it's not Frogfoot, it's Vumatel, it's not reliable and that is incorrect, right? So if I don't know who the fiber provider is for that specific neighborhood or that specific speed test, I'll just leave it out. If you don't have fiber in your neighborhood, I hope for you to get fiber soon. If you don't have fiber in your neighborhood, you can definitely choose any fiber infrastructure provider that you want, or you can go onto your internet service provider's website and register yourself to show interest, because it really does count. If you can show interest, then your neighbor can show interest, and then they can show interest, and then who knows, you might have fiber in your neighborhood being installed in the next few months, right? understand that in South Africa, there's only two ways of getting internet right now. It's either fiber or 5G. ADSL, they've cut it out. Copper, they're the whole thing, they're not doing it anymore. So if you go to Telkom and you ask them to pull a copper line for you, they will tell you,
"You're on the best thing, which I can advise
you to go home and eat maguinhas in your mother's kitchen." So yeah. Other than that, dank jullie mensen wel voor mijn video bekijken. En ik hoop dat jullie mensen gaan een goede dag hebben. Bedankt mensen en tot ziens.